Hello students, in this video we are going to understand what is conservation of linear momentum and we will prove the conservation of linear momentum also. We will derive the equation for conservation of linear momentum. So let us understand what is conservation of linear momentum. Conservation means constant. According to this law, the total momentum of the system remains constant when no external unbalanced force is acting on the body. Here, very important point to be noted is that when no external force acts on the body or the system, then the system is said to be isolated. Again, I am repeating, according to this law, the total momentum of the system remains constant for an isolated system of bodies. That is, the sum of initial momentum before collision is equal to sum of final momentum after collision. This is the expression, that is sum of which I told you right now. That is, sum of initial momentum is equal to sum of final momentum is known as the expression for the conservation of linear momentum. Now, let us come to the proof of conservation of linear momentum. So, here remember that there is no external force acting on the system of the bodies, then such kind of system of body is said to be an isolated system. Let us come to the proof of conservation of linear momentum. Let us suppose body 1 or body A of mass m1, which is moving with initial velocity u1, and body B, which is moving with initial velocity u2. Now, here you can see before collision, the speed of body A is greater than speed of body B. Before collision, the speed of body A is greater than body B. That is, u1 is greater than u2. As a result, the two bodies collide. When u1 is greater than u2, the two bodies collide. So this is during collision. This is the scene before collision. Now when u1 is greater than u2, the two bodies collide. As a result, first body applies force on second body and second body applies the force on first body. So the force applied by second body on first body is given by F12 and the force on the second body by first body is given by F21. These two forces make action and reaction pair. If suppose F12 is the action, then according to Newton's third law, to every action there is equal and opposite reaction force, then F12 is equal to minus F21. Now, this collision takes place for very small interval of time. Let us suppose this interval of time, that is collision time, is small t. After collision, the two bodies starts moving with different velocities. Let us suppose first body is moving with v1 velocity and the second body starts moving with v2 velocity. So these are what the suppositions which you have to mention for the derivation of conservation of linear momentum expression. So initial momentum of first body is equal to m1 u1. Final momentum of the first body is equal to m1 v1. Momentum, linear momentum, is the product of mass and velocity. So mass for the first body is m1 and initial velocity is u1. So initial momentum of first body is m1 u1, and final momentum of the first body is m1 v1. Similarly, for the second body, we have initial momentum is equal to m2 u2, and final momentum of second body is equal to m2 v2. Momentum again is product of mass and velocity. So initial momentum of second body is m2 u2, mass of second body is m2, and u2 is the initial velocity of the body. So initial momentum of second body is m2 u2, and final momentum of the body is m2 v2. Now we will find out the change in momentum of the first body. So change in momentum of first body. So change in momentum of first body is equal to final momentum minus initial momentum. So final momentum of first body is m1 v1, and initial momentum of first body is m1 u1. Now since the collision lasts for t time, that is collision time is t for both the bodies, for body first and for body second, collision time is same. So we will find out rate of change of linear momentum. So when you divide any physical quantity by time, then it becomes rate of change of linear momentum. So rate of change of linear momentum is equal to change in momentum upon collision time. So change in momentum for the first body is equal to m1 v1 minus m1 u1, and collision time is t. Now according to Newton's second law, the change in momentum is directly proportional to force applied. Force applied is directly proportional to rate of change of momentum. So F21 is the force applied on second body by first body. According to Newton's second law, it will be equal to m1 v1 minus m1 u1 upon t. Let us suppose this is equation number 1. Now similarly for the second body, rate of change of momentum is equal to m2 v2 minus m2 u2 upon t. And according to Newton's second law, this rate of change of momentum is equal to the force applied by the body. So the force applied by the second body on first body is equal to 1 to F12. It is equal to m2 v2 minus m2 u2 upon t. Let us suppose this is equation number 2. Now, by Newton's third law, to every action there is opposite reaction force. So if F12 is action, then F21 is reaction, and negative sign shows that reaction force acts in the opposite direction. Now, keeping the values of F12 and F21 from equation number 1 and equation number 2. So, from equation number 1, we have F21 is equal to M1V1 minus M1U1 upon T, and F12 is equal to M2U2 minus M2V2 minus M2U2 upon T. So let us keep this value here. So M2V2 minus M2U2 upon T is equal to M1V1 minus M1U1 upon T. Now remember that to enclose the value of F21 in bracket, because to every action there is equal and opposite reaction force. Now this T gets cancelled out and you will be left over with the term M2V2 minus M2U2 is equal to. Now remember that you are opening the bracket with negative sign, so all the sign gets reversed. You will get minus M1V1 and plus M1U1 plus M1U1. Now you will take U terms to one side and you will take V terms to one side, or you can say M2V2. Now this M1V1 is minus here. So when you transpose this to left side, you will get plus M1V1 is equal to M1U1 is already here. So M1U1, now this M2U2 is taken to right side. So it becomes plus M2U2 is the required expression for conservation of linear momentum. From this expression you will see M2V2 plus M1V1 is the sum of final linear momentum is equal to sum of initial linear momentum. When this happens during the collision, then the momentum remains conserved. Hence, you can conclude that sum of final momentum is equal to sum of initial momentum. Hence, the momentum remains conserved, that is, P remains constant, or you can say conserve, for isolated system of bodies. Isolated system of bodies. This is how we will derive the expression for conservation of linear momentum. Now let us move to the applications which are based on conservation of linear momentum. Recoiling of gun is based on conservation of linear momentum, and it is also based on action and reaction pair. Recoiling of gun is because of action and reaction pair, action and reaction law. So when a bullet is fired from the gun moves to the backward direction by certain distance. This movement of the gun to backward direction by certain distance is known as recoiling of gun. And the velocity by which the gun moves backward is known as recoil velocity of the gun. So, let us come to the derivation for recoiling of gun. Recoiling of gun. So, for this system, you know that gun forms a system before firing. Bullet and gun forms a system before firing. So, gun plus bullet are at rest. Therefore, the sum of their initial momentum is zero. Since the gun and bullet are at rest, therefore, the sum of initial momentum is zero. Since no external force act on the system, therefore, momentum of gun plus bullet after firing should also be zero. Because according to conservation law of linear momentum, sum of initial momentum is equal to sum of final momentum of the system. So, since sum of initial momentum of gun plus bullet is zero, therefore, according to conservation law of linear momentum, sum of final momentum should also be zero for gun and bullet system. So, let us suppose that small m is the mass of bullet, capital M is the mass of gun, small v is the velocity of bullet, capital V is the recoil velocity of gun. So, sum of initial momentum for gun plus bullet system is equal to zero. Why? Because initially both are at rest. Gun is also at rest and bullet is also at rest. So, sum of initial momentum is zero. Now, sum of final momentum will be equal to the final momentum of gun plus final momentum of bullet. So, final momentum of gun is capital M into V and final momentum of bullet is small m into V. Now, according to conservation law of linear momentum, sum of final momentum is equal to sum of initial momentum. So, sum of initial momentum is zero. Hence, MV plus MV is equal to zero. Now, MV plus MV is equal to 0. So, capital MV plus small MV is equal to 0. As sum of final momentum is equal to sum of initial momentum. Sum of initial momentum of the system. So, according to the conservation law of linear momentum, sum of initial momentum of the system is equal to sum of final momentum of the system. Sum of initial momentum is zero as bullet and gun both are at rest. Hence, sum of initial momentum is zero and sum of final momentum is equal to MV plus MV MV. Hence, according to conservation law, MV plus MV is equal to zero. Now, we need to find out the recoil velocity. Therefore, we will transpose MV is equal to this MV we will transpose to the right side. You will get a small MV. You need to find out recoil velocity. So, you will transpose this m to the right side and you will get a small m upon capital M into V. This is the relation for recoil velocity of the gun. So, you can see the negative sign in this relation, which shows that after firing, recoiling of the gun will be in the backward direction because the bullet after before bullet during firing moves in the forward direction, hence recoiling of the gun will be in the backward direction. So in physics, when direction is opposite, we show it by negative sign. Another important aspect from this relation is that recoil velocity is inversely proportional to mass of gun. You can see from this relation, V is in numerator and capital M is in denominator. So this kind of relation is inverse relation. So during inverse relation, capital V is inversely proportional to, this is mass of gun. From relation you have seen V is proportional to capital M, that is recoil velocity of gun is inversely proportional to mass of gun. So if the mass of gun is higher, recoil velocity will be less, and if the mass of the gun is less, then recoil velocity will be higher. So you can imagine that for the gun of lighter mass, that is the gun which has lighter mass, has more recoil velocity, that is it will offer more jerk on your shoulder, hence you will be badly injured in comparison to the heavier gun. So lighter gun recoils with more velocity, hence injury on your shoulder will be more than heavier gun. So suppose it is, the question is asked that which gun will hurt more, lighter gun or the heavier gun, then the answer is the lighter gun will hurt more than the heavier gun, as you have seen that the recoil velocity of the gun is inversely proportional to mass of gun. So if the mass of gun is less, recoil velocity will be more and hurting will be more, and if mass of gun is more, then recoil velocity will be less and you will be less hurt by the heavier gun. So in the next video we will solve the numericals based on the Newton's second law.